Come on, you could do better than that. This isn't a Doctor Who cosplay video. If you're gonna do a video like this, we need something with a little bit more of a kick, something to kickstart the video. How about this? Hello everyone out there on YouTube and followers of Who Cosplays. Today we have a very, very special cosplay video indeed. For once, it's not Doctor Who related at all. This time, we are going to be taking a look at my newest cosplay, which is the Captain America Winter Soldier Stealth Suit cosplay. Now, essentially what I'm going to do is show you the costume I've had made, where I got it from, and just show you how the whole look is when it's all put together. Before I get started, I will just like to give you some basic background on some of the items. Apart from three of the items, all the items here you are seeing can be bought from cosplaysky.com. That's www.cosplaysky.com, and they all come as one complete set. You can buy them at your own custom measurements. They have complete instructions on how to measure yourself for the items, and you can have it custom made so it fits you a bit more perfectly than if you had a generic size. It does cost a bit of money, but when you see the items I have for you today, you will understand why it costs such a fair amount of money. So without further ado, I will begin with what I have to show you. And I'll start off, as I always do, with the boots. Now, anybody who has seen my Who cosplays may recognise these boots as the boots I use for Matt Smith as the 11th Doctor. These are the boots I'm going to be using for my cosplay. These can be bought from River Island. They are zipped up on the side, and they are very, very close to what you can get for the Captain America cosplay. But it's not really that important for the boots, as Captain America, you don't really get much focus on his legs, unless he's kicking somebody. So you can get yourself a pair of military boots or a pair of boots like this, and then the leg guards will do the rest. Now we can move on to talk about the main parts of the costume. It essentially consists of three or four different parts, if you discount the gloves. It's essentially a top half, which is the uniform, the trousers, and then you have his belt and the shield strap. So to start off with, I'll talk about the gloves and the belt, which I have here. The gloves are made out of an artificial leather material. The majority of the costume is made of this and some fabric. They're very, very nice gloves. One size fits all. They are Velcro strapped and they are very, very close to what you can actually get on from the film. The film versions, they're a bit more brown and there's none of this blue. However, these look very, very nice all the same. As you can see, stitched together quite nicely. You've got these lovely silver bits which are sewed on for the different materials. And these do fit virtually all sizes. As you can see, you just put them on like that and there you go. They fit really well. They're not like some gloves that are too big and difficult to clench your fist, and the holes and everything make it look very, very nice, as you can see here. I'll just show you what both gloves together look like on. Oh, come on, Velcro. There we are. As you can see, very, very nice, and you can, when you've got the whole suit on, you can do a couple of punches and etc. While wearing these gloves. So, now that we've got the gloves sorted, let's talk about the belt. Essentially, they're all the same. This one is made out of the artificial leather, like most of the costume, as I said before. And it's done very, very close to the original belt. You've got the silver fabrics stitched on at the back. You have all the different leather parts here. And you have the pouches going over the belt, one on that side, and then four on the other side there. Now, these pouches aren't usable, unfortunately. They have a little bit of a flap for you to stick your finger through, but you can't open them and use them. But the good thing about this one is the buckle is actually metal. That's one good thing about this cosplay, which is how much metal they actually use for it, so the price is understandable. And all you need to do to put this belt on is undo the buckle, like so, and wrap it round you, and then strap it on. And then, if I just tilt the camera down a little bit for you, there we are, you can see the belt here, and it fits quite nicely on here when I'm not wearing the suit. When you put the suit on, it does fit a lot better. Now this belt is a bit big sometimes, but that's just to cover up the seam of the top and bottom parts of your suit. The trousers that come with this suit are very, very good. Make sure you get your waist measurement and leg length right, and these are going to do you very, very well indeed. Make sure you specify them very clearly, as you don't want to end up with trousers that are too big or too short. But essentially, these are also artificial leather and polyester, and these are just a very dark navy blue, as you can see there. They have a button at the front there, which you won't be able to see so well on camera, but that button isn't going to be seen when wearing the costume anyway, because you will have the belt on, so you don't need to worry about that. But as you can see at the front, you have the polyester material here and here and around the knee pad, which is featured on the suit. This is a very, very close replica to the actual trousers he wears. In fact, I'd almost go so far as to say it's 100% accurate, just not necessarily the material. On the sides here, you have a dark red stripe, and on the other leg as well. There's no white featured on this costume, as this is the stealth suit. You also have two pockets which actually work. You can fit your phone and you can fit an iPod or even a pistol if you're doing the First Avenger style Captain America, or you just need some more accessories to go with it. And they are both fully functional pockets like that, and they also have a little bit of a red stripe above them as well for a little bit of extra detail. And on the back as well, you have more straps, and you have the rest of the seams and the little extra bits as well. So the trousers are very, very nice. This makes one half of the main bulk of the costume, and we'll see how they look in a little bit later. But for now, it's time to move on to the highlight of the entire suit, which is the actual upper part of the uniform. Now the upper part of this uniform is the most impressive part of the whole suit. This is what you're paying your money for mainly, because this has got the most metal, and it's got the most fabric, and it's got the most detail. Essentially artificial leather again, as you can see, with polyester here and here. And then you have this little bit of material here as well to do the silver stripes. Now, the thing I love about this jacket is you can wear it as a normal coat, if you don't want to just cosplay, but what I like is the level of detail and the extra features they have. For most notably, the star. Now if you look at the star, it's got all the segmentations of the actual star from the film and the little lines and everything, but also that star is solid metal. They've actually gone to the trouble of making the star in this suit a proper metal one as opposed to the fabric. So if you want a really nice star for your Captain America suit, then you'll want to go with this suit. And this was one of the reasons I went with this, as the rest were just made out of a material. As you can see, you've got all the different sections here, the stitching and the sewing details, the little bit of pads as well. This isn't padded very much at all. This is custom made on my waist and chest sizes as well, and my arm length, so make sure you specify those measurements when getting your coat. You have a collar here made out of polyester as well, which is very, very nice, and two Velcro patches for the shield straps and buckles, which we'll get onto a little bit later. On the sides, you have an American flag patch, which is featured on the costume, if you've seen the films, which I'm guessing you have. And that's very nicely stitched on, and got very dark versions of the colours of the flag, as this is a stealth suit. And on the other side, you have an actual shield patch as well, of the shield organisation logo. So the attention to detail on this is fantastic. And then if we take a look at the back, you have a zip, as you have to put this on from the back. You will need help when putting this costume on. And then you have this material going across the back as well, as it did in the film. So that's very, very good detail, and I do like the extra little details of the polyester fabric going down here, with the little hexagons there as well. Other than that, the other main detail is that the red, white and blue featured is not really featured on here. You have the blue and the red, as this is the stealth suit as mentioned. So the red stripes are just here on the suit, just at the sides. They are dark red and they feature on both sides of the costume, so you get a little bit of that normal Captain America flavour, and that is just in red polyester as well, and that is very, very nice attention to detail. So when choosing a suit, make sure you pay close attention to this, as this will be a major selling point if you decide to purchase a suit, as this is brilliant. And like I said, you can wear it as a normal coat as well. Fantastic! The last part of the costume I have to show you is, of course, the shield buckle that Captain America carries with the straps. Now, this is another piece. This has the buckle which he clips his shield onto. Again, that is solid metal. It's a very rough metal, but it's very, very nice, and it's in the exact shape of the actual emblem seen on screen. You can't use this with the shield I have, unfortunately, to put your shield on, but you can try if you want to, although I do have an alternative method which I'll show you later. Essentially, it's again made out of the artificial leather fabric, and there are two Velcro tags on the bottoms of this part which clip onto the front of your coat and form the rest of the collar. And then what you do is you basically put the straps over your shoulders and you have the shield belt, essentially. And what you also have here are artificial leather straps with the little silver patches on, and more metal buckles. Now, I love the fact that they included metal buckles, as it just makes it look that bit more real. So this is a very, very nice feature, so I really recommend, if you haven't been sold already, if you want a Captain America cosplay, go to Cosplay Sky, as they are brilliant. So that's everything I have to say about the costume. So now we get on to my personal favourite part of this, talking about the shield, and of course, when you put the suit on, the whole thing comes together a little bit like this. As you can see, the whole look comes together very, very nicely. This suit is fantastic, and as you can see, this fits me pretty well. There is a little bit of padding here, but that's just because of the belt pushing it up. But other than that, this fits absolutely perfect. The belt holds it together nicely, so you can't really see the seam of the two separate pieces. If you can't see that on camera, there will be pictures on the website for you. Remember, cosplaysky.com. And the gloves with the Velcro help to cover up the seam between the arms and the start, and the end of the arms and the start of the gloves. So that comes together very, very nicely. The straps fit really, really well, as you can see, with the back buckle here on the back where the shield would go as well. So these straps sit very, very nicely all together, and I'm very, very pleased with this cosplay, and hopefully if any of you are watching this want to do your own, you'll go to Cosplay Sky. This whole costume to put together will cost you in the region of £167, maybe a little bit more if you decide to go for custom made. I know mine was a bit more expensive. Just make sure you get your measurements spot on first time, and you will have a costume to call your own, and you will be Captain America. However, no Captain America cosplay is complete without that quintessential item that the Captain always has with him, which is, of course, the shield. Here is the shield. This is made of PVC, and this is fantastic. I originally had a shield made of metal, but that didn't look very, very good, and I was looking for a more accurate one. Now, those of you who can't own the official Marvel replica, this would be an ideal choice for you. And once again, this comes from Cosplay Sky, made from PVC. This costs £60, but to be fair, it is worth it. You get a gloss red, white, and blue paint job over the PVC. The star is embossed over the front. It does stick out a little bit on the shield, and as you can hear, it is pretty sturdy. This comes with two straps. It comes with a leather strap and an elastic strap. It's not the same straps as you would get on the official replica, but they do the job very, very well. All you have to do is put the bolts through them and you have the shield complete. If I turn that round, as you can see, there are the straps and the bolts, leather here for the short arm, and this for the other strap, the elastic one here, which is very, very useful, and I'll tell you why in a moment. Now, obviously the other side of this is supposed to be silver on the official Marvel one, so if you want, you can just get a little bit of spray paint and just spray the inside of the shield. Just make sure you don't overspray the edges. This costs £60 at Cosplay Sky, and thrown together with this costume, I believe this shield is fantastic. So there we are, my Captain America cosplay to date with a shield. And as you can see, this shield looks very, very nice. I will be going around Stoke-on-Trent this year with pride, wielding the shield of Captain America. And this is a very, very nice shield. I can't sing this shield praises enough. It's very lightweight. You can swing it around. You can do all sorts of Captain America poses with it. And with this look, it does look very, very nice. So remember, Cosplay Sky, £60 for the shield. Those of you who are wondering if this shield is compatible with the back strap, as I've said, it can't unfortunately attach to the buckle, as the elastic will just make it hang down, and the other strap you may damage, so you won't want to do that. However, the elastic strap, as I mentioned, does have one advantage, which is if you do this and put your right arm or left arm, depending on which arm you use your shield with, you can simply put it over your arm like so, and there you are. It fits very, very nicely on your back. And you can have the shield walking around you without having to carry it on your arm all the time. And you can have that little bit more neutral Captain America pose, or you can do the pose you see a lot in the publicity images of him holding his belt with the shield on his back. Final thoughts. If you are a fan of Captain America at all, or you're a fan of the Winter Soldier, you're a fan of the Winter Soldier look, then definitely try and track down this costume on Cosplay Sky and get your own right now, because it is absolutely brilliant, and you can get the shield as well. Personally, all I think it needs is some boots thrown in with it, or maybe Cosplay Sky should start selling the leg guards, and then you're set. If you're looking for the leg guards, you can get those from eBay. Just type in Captain America Accessories The Winter Soldier. It will be the American eBay, which is not, and they cost $99, but you do get another strap thrown in, and you get a belt and another pair of gloves. But they're all made of proper leather, and the leg guards will just give your costume that little bit more accuracy and give you that special Captain America feel. So thank you for watching this special cosplay video, guys. It's been a long time in the making. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope that you will tune into my Stoke-on-Trent video in April to see this costume in all of its glory on the streets of Stoke-on-Trent. So for now, this is Captain America signing off. Captain America, and you are watching The Pandorica Opens. See you when the Avengers next assemble.
No strings on me.